11, probably 220 pounds. Now Chad's probably 6'1 and a half, 6'2, about 250. And so he's really matured, gotten bigger. He's a heck of a football player, really unique guy. He's one of the top BMX racers, bicycle racers as a kid. Really, really good athlete. Like, he comes from a great family. One of those kids that's going to do well in whatever he decides to do well in. And kind of like we talked about earlier with Johnny Reagan, he takes a lot of pride in everything he does. You can see, very physical. Really, really hard to find a true middle linebacker. And Chad's a true physical, hard-nosed, tough middle linebacker. And again, a great student. He's a fantastic student. This is Matt Anderson. Matt's enrolled in school right now. He's a kicker. I don't know what else I can say. That's right. He's got a great haircut. He's really, really good, consistent, strong leg. You know, one of the kicking gurus, all swear by him. We're a very highly rated kicker. Obviously, you can see the strength of his leg there. The guy we're very excited about. One thing he does well is gets the ball up quickly. I think that's one thing that separates a lot of good kickers from great kickers is how quickly does he get the ball up, and his ball really gets up in the air quickly and is less likely to get blocked as a result. Chris Barreo, a real tough, hard-nosed kid, a great wrestler. We think has a chance to win the state championship in his weight class in wrestling. Really, really physical, plays hard, finishes blocks. Kind of is the type of guy that we look for at the guard position. I think there's a chance of probably end up as a guard, we'll see. But that's kind of what we look for. Physical, hard-nosed, tough kid that again can finish. And very strong, plays low with good leverage. There's Eric Bunt. He's a huge guy. Eric's 6'7", well over 300 pounds. Very physical. You know, a good athlete for somebody that's his size. And I think sometimes when you get a guy that's that tall and that big, they have a tendency to not bend very well. He bends very well, and again, he's a good athlete for somebody that's his size. Comes off the ball well. Aaron Cochran, everybody knows his brother plays for us. Aaron's a huge guy. Got a great frame. Again, like Eric that we talked about earlier, he really bends well. You can see he's a great athlete, runs well, plays basketball. I think this kid has a chance to be a really, really good one. You can see he's got a lot of strength and does a good job getting up to the next level. He's probably 6'7". Yeah, probably. It's probably close. Closest. I mean, sometimes when they get over 6'6", it's hard to tell. You know, you just know they call after that. You know, sometimes it's hard on the small guys because they may be blocking a 5'8" guy, and so that guy's on their knees all the time. And again, both he and Eric Bunt do a good job keeping their pads low. J.D. Hinnett, he really liked the way he plays. You know, he had a ton of offers. He was a heavily recruited kid. He was involved in a car wreck, a pretty serious car wreck, and has really made a kind of a miraculous recovery. He's doing incredibly well, and really like the way this guy plays. Very athletic, finishes well, got good toughness, really persistent the way he plays. Benny Johnson, called the microwave. Benny's kind of a guy that we got on a little bit late. We love his athleticism. He's got a great frame. Really, really smart kid. Again, somebody that was really excited about the Cal education. But you can see here now, he moves his feet really well. And Benny's one of those guys. He's about 255, 260 right now. I mean, he'll be 280 fast, 290 fast, probably be, you know, a 300-pound guy before long. And again, this guy has a lot of upside. Really, really moves his feet well. Fantastic student. He plays tough, plays physical. Ray Hudson, we talked about Ray earlier. He's kind of a unique blend. You can see here he's playing some wide receiver. Big guy that catches the ball very well. Is pretty nimble for somebody that's his size. And very, very versatile. Can do a lot of different things. Jack Austin, I think Jack's got a real bright future ahead of him. Got really good ball skills. I think he was one of those guys that was way under-recruited. Fits our offense perfectly. He's a good route runner. He's got great hands. Smart kid. Makes a lot of competitive catches. You'll see almost all these catches, he's got people on him. And does a great job going up and getting the ball. He has really, really good size and strength. He would be one trying my best. Have a chance to play early, but we'll see how it plays out. Caleb Coleman, again, somebody we felt like was a little undervalued. You know, I think Caleb runs well, real productive. He's got excellent hands. You know, I think he's got a chance to be a really good player.
Thank you.
know, you'll see him. He does a nice job working the pocket. I think that's a skill that's very underrated. It's being comfortable and being able to move your feet and adjust in the pocket. You can see he does that a lot before he makes throws. And, you know, I think the quarterbacks that usually do that are guys that can get on the field pretty quickly. It's really a learned skill. It's not something guys do, you know, do naturally. Obviously had a very successful year, which I think, again, is a direct reflection on the quarterback and how well he played and got his team to the state championship.